calling it a love song. Hey my gemstones, it's Mary Gem and I'm back with another video, and today's video is going to be on who is busy gossiping about you, you know, who's talking about you behind your back and everything. So we've got 6 piles yesterday and we also have channel messages as well. So these are the 6 piles, please pick whichever one resonates. I'm not going to be doing the close-ups this time. You guys can just, you know, pick whichever one resonates, pause the video, take as much time as you need as well. But yeah, so we've got pile number 1 with the brown, we've got pile number 2 with a star, pile 3 we've got the flower, pile 4 we got like a yellow background with like some pink as well, like it looks like nail polish low-key. Pile number 5 we got a cup, and then inside the cup is like some like salt mix or bath salts basically. And then pile number 6 we have a plant. So yeah, these are the 6 piles, please pick whichever one resonates, and yeah, let's get straight into the video. What is up my gemstones, let's get straight into your reading. So pile number 1, who is busy gossiping about you? Honestly, I'm super excited for this video, and like the next video is going to be who's jealous of you, and I don't know why, but like I've been wanting to make this video so bad. But yeah, anyways, let's get straight into it. So this is going to be a channel message. I'm super sorry that we don't have any songs, but definitely I'll make sure that the next video does have songs. But yeah, anyways, so your overall energy is going to be the maybe I was wrong card. And yeah, so I was getting a couple messages that came in before I even get started into the reading. Like I heard someone say kicking you when you're down, and then I also heard someone say that truly I'm not over this connection yet. So there's a lot of different things that are coming up, definitely pile one. A lot of emotional energy, a lot of like, you know, like I just feel like it's like fair game, but it's also like, I don't know, a lot of different energy. So yeah, let's just get into it though. Let's get the cards, let's see what everything is, okay? So who is busy gossiping about you? We've got the magician card that came up, right? Okay. I'm trying to think, is there enough light? Okay, magician card that came up, we got the shady card, definitely bro. So if you're wondering, is even anyone gossiping about you? 1000% bro. We got the hangman that came up, right? Mm-hmm. We got the hermit card. Oh my gosh bro, the wheel of fortune, and then the ten of cups that came up, right? Oh my gosh, literally it feels kind of like this person definitely did a full circle, where it's kind of like, you know, they were at first they were like, you know, gossiping and talking about you, but then it's like with the wheel of fortune things ended up changing, and they ended up actually like, you know, finding out actually like, you know, you're a good person basically, because there's a lot going on to this bro for real. But let me show you the cards first. We've got literally 1 2 3 4 bro, 4 major arcana cards. Wow. So yeah, we've got the wheel of we've got the magician card that came up, and then we also got the shady card. And then at the back of the magician, it says talents, compatibilities, full potential, not holding back, and transforming something, okay? And then we've got the maybe I was wrong card being the overall energy. Let's get into your channeled message. So it says, who is busy gossiping about you? Older people, someone who you met once. When I first met you, I was told some things about you. I believed the lies, and now I realize I was wrong, and it's none of my business. Was I wrong? So obviously we've got the synchronicities between the was I wrong and the maybe I was wrong card. So that's already like a good sign. But I feel like wow, it's a lot of different energies. So definitely the person that's busy gossiping about you, just someone that like really is just, they have way too much free time. I really feel like that's like who they are. Like it's someone that's definitely older than you, or just someone that you just met once, you know, and it's kind of like they already made their biases on you just off of like, you know, meeting you one time basically, you know. With the maybe I was wrong card, I just get the vibe where it's kind of like they really did judge you on like your first appearance, and like they judged you like by what you were wearing, something, you know. Maybe they saw you like, okay, this is gonna sound really bad maybe, but like you guys wanted to watch this video. So like, don't come for me, okay? I love you, but excuse me, like maybe you weren't wearing something very nice. Like I'm getting like, you know, when it comes to your appearance or something, like I can see them saying, oh wow, like, you know, your hair was dirty when I first met you. I can see them saying, oh, like your clothes weren't neat or something. Or I'm getting the vibe where it's like something about like your physical appearance. I can see them saying, yeah, like I just can see them like, you know, nitpicking things and like, you know, gossiping about you when it comes to something about what you were wearing, or like something about your hair, you know, maybe like I see being dirty, or I can see them saying like your clothes weren't that neat or something, you know. And I can just see them, you know, being very biased and just like, you know, judging you off like I said, a first appearance and first impressions basically. And yeah, they say some things about you, and now it's like they realize that basically they were wrong and they shouldn't have done that. So I definitely feel that this person has realized like, you know, they shouldn't like, you know, gossip, and like they realize that like they shouldn't have said those things about you basically. And I definitely feel like there is a vibe where it's like they feel bad about it, you know, like although we don't have the I'm sorry card or like, you know, we don't have any signs of like remorse, I definitely feel like they did. No, there is like signs of remorse. So with the hangman, you know, I feel like they definitely do feel bad about it. So yeah, let's get into it. With the magician card, I really feel like this might be someone that's very successful when it comes to, you know, their job or their career. Like, I can see them having a very high end paying job. Like, I just feel like they make a lot of money, definitely, you know. They might make more money than you, and I just feel like it's someone that really has no business, you know, like, looking down on people. But I feel like for fun, maybe they enjoy making fun of people. I just feel like they really look at people's clothing. Like, I'm just getting the vibe where it's like they were making fun of your clothing or something, or they were talking about your hands, your nails, something like that, you know. Maybe you're wearing something that like wasn't a real brand, or like you were, like I said, wearing something, doing something, and I can just see them saying like gossiping about you, saying something like, you know, under their breath, like, you know, just like saying something not very nice, basically. Even though this came upright, I feel like low-key this came in reverse. So, but I do get the vibe where it's like there's someone that's definitely very talented, and I feel like they're very good at their job as well, though, definitely, you know. And yeah, like I said, a high end paying job, 1000%, and they're older than you. But I get the vibe where it's like they work in a corporate or something, like they work in a really, really big office or something, a really big building. And they might even have their own office as well. But yeah, they make a lot of good money, and like they're very successful when it comes to, you know, their job or whatever. Like, I get the vibe where it's like people rely on this person a lot because like they're really good at their job a lot, though, definitely. Like, for some reason this reminds me of my dad, because it's like at his job, it's like literally if he were to like even just leave his job, it's like everything would just fall apart. Okay, then maybe I'm exaggerating, but like that's the vibe where it's like people really rely on this person a lot for their judgment and everything. So yeah, but I feel like this person definitely someone that's very shady, though, you know. It's like although like, you know, they do well very financially, or like they are very talented in their skills, it's kind of like they're someone that's very shady, you know. I feel like they give people fail kaka me bro, they give you fail kaka are you knee yours about to start looking up in your man. Anyways, let me speak English. I feel like power one, this is just someone that's very shady, and when I said fail kaka in English, that means dirty look. So I definitely feel like I just feel like you might know who they are. Or it's kind of like, yeah, I feel like you might know who they are. Like, even if you don't know them personally, I just feel like you might know who I'm talking about, because it's kind of like you have an inkling, because maybe you had an interaction with someone. It was very brief, very quickly, but it's like you could tell this person was like, you know, looking at you and everything. Because I get the vibe where it's like they gave you a dirty look. Like, they gave you like a fail look, like whatever. So yeah, they gave you a dirty look, basically, and that's how you'll know who they are. But with the hangman that came up, but I really feel like, you know, they truly felt really bad afterwards, you know. I feel like they were like, oh, I shouldn't have judged you or something, or I just feel like maybe they ended up seeing you again, or they ended up talking to you and they were like, oh damn, like you're like such a nice person, wow, that was really shitty of me, wow, that really sucks, you know what I mean. Like, I get the vibe where it's like they were proven wrong about something, you know. Maybe they spoke about you to someone, and then like, you know, that person that they spoke to about you or gossiping about you to ended up, you know, being your friend, or ended up being someone that like knew you, and then they were like, and this person might have been like, listen, actually this person's like, you know, really dope, like actually they're just having a bad day right now, you know, don't say that stuff, you know. And I can see them being like, oh shit, you know, like I just feel like I can see them saying something aloud and then being like, oh shit, I shouldn't have said that, you know. Like, for some reason, I've been thinking about, you know, Orange is the New Black. I'm not going to say any spoilers, but, like, this is one episode where this one person talks about how the food is so awful. And then she ends up actually insulting the cook. And then the cook is like, or the chef. And the chef's like, that I'm the chef, or, you know. And then it's kind of like, oh, man, I say too much, you know. And I feel like that's how they basically feel. And with the Hermit card, I just feel like there's someone that definitely is, like, a huge loner as well. I feel like they don't have that many friends. And like I said, they have a lot of free time on their hands as well. It's like, although they, like, you know, they work a lot, I just feel like they don't have that many friends, you know. When it comes to their free time, it's kind of like they spend most of their free time at home. Or, like, you know, going to the mall and just, like, you know, walking around shopping and, like, not really, you know, spending time with their friends. Like, I feel like they might go out, but, like, they prefer going out by themselves as well. Yeah, like, whenever they go out, like, they're usually alone or something. And, like, maybe, like, you know those people that talk in the lines? Like, you know, when you're, like, in a line to buy something, I can even see it being someone, like, gossiping about you. Like, they saw you while you were, like, you know, in a line to buy something. And I can see them saying, oh, look at this person. Like, what was he wearing or something, you know? Like, I get the vibe where it's, like, they were gossiping about you, but, like, they were alone. Like, nobody was, they weren't gossiping with anyone else, you know? like, yeah, they were, like, gossiping to themselves, basically. And then with the Wheel of Fortune, they changed their mind. They realized that, like, you know, that was wrong. They shouldn't have said that. And I feel like with the Ten of Cups, like, they genuinely feel like you're actually a really nice person. And I can see them saying, like, maybe I was wrong. But then again, yeah, wait, it says, was I wrong, though, with the question mark. So it's, like, I feel like they're saying, you know, even if, like, what they said might be true about you, I can see them saying, like, it doesn't really matter, like, you know, it was wrong on their part, basically. And I feel like with the Ten of Cups, it's like they hope that, like, this doesn't, like, you don't hate them afterwards, or they hope that, like, you aren't mad at them, like, they hope that, like, you guys can still be friends, you know, whatever. Like, I can just see them saying, like, they want to approach, they want to apologize to you, basically, or they feel a lot of remorse, basically. And they just feel like that was wrong with them to basically, you know, say that or think that about you. Because they're saying, like, that's not an accurate representation of who they are as a person. And they're saying, like, you know, they feel bad about that now, basically. So, yeah, follow on. Let me know if you know who this person is, or, like, you know, what happened. Like, if you know what happened with this person or something. Because that's very interesting. So, yeah, let's get into the next one. What is our pile number two? Let's get straight into your reading. So, who's busy gossiping about you? I feel like this is going to be a very juicy reading. Because, firstly, for some reason, I literally heard the song You Don't Know Me by Jade West or Elizabeth Gills. I definitely will link the song down below, which is, like, You Don't Know Me. And, yeah, like, I'll link it down below. But anyway, so your overall energy is going to be the self-love. Of course, so definitely, you know, you might be, you know, loving yourself and just really, you know, in your own energy, in your own element. And I can just see people, like, you know, because maybe you're really, like, you know, loving yourself and, like, you know, you're being in the spotlight a lot recently. Because literally you guys chose pile number two and got the Star year, you know, that's the Aquarius card. Definitely you could be a air sign, and with the self-love card and everything, the butterfly transformation, I just feel like you're really in your own energy, like, you know, you're really glowing. And basically I feel like because of, like, you being in your own energy so much, it's kind of like you're attracting a lot of people in your life, you know, and, like, a lot of people that are good for you and also people that aren't so good for you as well. And my throat is, like, getting dry. Wait. But yeah, anyways, let's get straight into it. So I was hearing some channel messages, but now for some reason, like, they basically just escaped me. Okay, what was I hearing? Like, yeah, I heard them saying, like, you don't know me, so don't try to speak for me unless you don't know me, or, like, you don't know me, like, you know my name, not my story type vibe. So this might be someone that, like, they're, like, low-key maybe a secret admirer, but, like, not in, like, a good way. I mean, no, maybe it even is, like, a secret admirer. Like, I feel like it's someone that, like, just is, like, lurking in the shadows, basically. Like, I feel like it's someone that, like, has seen you around, and they kind of just, like, you know, had their eye on you for a while, and it's kind of like they didn't mean anything bad by it, but it's like they just, yeah, it's a long story, Paula, too, for real. Like, I feel like it's gonna be a long story. But yeah, let's get into it. So we've got the butterfly card that came up, right? Okay. And for some reason, I even want to link down the song, the Butterfly song by Austin and Ellie. Like, wow, why are there so many music, you know? Definitely go to your music gallery and press shuffle and see whatever song shows up as well. I'll do it also now, and then I'll put the song over here. So this is the song that came up for me. I don't have my phone with me right now, but yeah, anyways. We got the skeleton of the number three, okay? We got the King of Swords. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm getting the vibe where they're saying, it's not personal, bro. We've got the Chariot card, okay? We've got the Four of Wands. Oh, yeah, you guys also got the most cards. We've got the Knight of Wands, and then we also got the Four of Cups. I'll put this card over here so you guys can see it. Wow. So, we've got the Transformation card with the Butterfly. We've got the Number Three and the Skeleton. Yeah, Protected Energy, okay? And then we also got the Self-Love card, guys. Honestly, self-love is so important, y'all, for real. So, keep doing your boo thing. Keep doing you. It doesn't matter who's gossiping about you, okay? So it says, I wasn't trying to tear you down. I just felt like you didn't want to hear my side of the story. I have feelings and faults too, so I don't regret it. If you want to talk, let's talk. Guys, this person sounds so intimidating, but they're like, let's talk, bro. Like, okay, sis, I see you. Alrighty. Let's get into the self-love card first. So I get the vibe, but it's kind of like this is more of your energy, but, like, okay, I'll say it's the energy as well, though, because now that I'm seeing it, it's kind of like, okay, maybe it's the energy, but, like, roles can definitely be vice versa. But I get the vibe part too, that definitely this is someone that kind of was trying to excuse me. I just feel like they might be feeling like they finally they finally feel like they're being in the spot, or they kind of feel like they finally got the recognition that they've always been waiting for, that they've always been wanting. And I can kind of feel like they've been gossiping about you because, like, they felt like maybe they deserve more recognition and not you, you know. It's similar to, say now you're at school or something and you just finished a project, you know, and then it's like you end up getting 98% and it's like you didn't even put that much effort in, and then there's someone else in the class that also did a project but like they got now 95% and you got 97%, right? And I can just see them being like, that is so unfair, I put so much effort and time into what I was doing and it's like you just got yours for like doing nothing, you know. Like low-key, you know, the Coraline or Caroline Ford, which is like, I'm never the one, they don't pick me for anything. I just feel like this person feels like they feel like they were trying so hard, they feel like they love themselves, they feel like they do everything right, you know, but they just feel like everyone keeps gravitating towards you and they kind of feel like they're low-key living in your shadows, you know. Like I was getting the vibe where it's like living in your shadows, and I can see them like, you know, saying like they're not trying to be malicious, like, you know, they're not trying to be rude, like they're not trying to do any of that stuff, but it's kind of like they just felt like maybe they were really upset or something, and I can see them like, you know, wanting to let off steam basically. Yeah, they say that you didn't want to hear their side of the story. With the butterfly card, I kind of feel like maybe you might have left this person in the past, you know, maybe you were friends with them in the past, or like in the past, but it's kind of like you guys aren't friends anymore, and like you've just really, like, you know, changed and grown as a person. I just feel like you aren't really, you know, into the same things as you were before in the past, you know. Maybe in the past you were obsessed with, like, you know, they just say you're obsessed with, like, you know, wearing chunky shoes, but now it's kind of like you prefer high heels or something, you know what I mean. So it's like you just evolved, you changed your style, like, you know, you've just grown as a person, and I can just see this person being like, that's so unfair, why did you change without me, like, you know, you should ask my permission before you change, basically, you know. Like, this is a vibe where it's kind of like you've grown and this person has basically stayed exactly the same. And yeah, I just feel like that's why they're gossiping about you, because it's not like even jealousy. I just feel like, okay, it could definitely be jealousy, but I feel like it's also like they're saying that they feel like, yeah, they wanted you to hear their side of the story about something, because I just feel like maybe I can see them trying to talk to you, and I can just see you being like very dismissive to them. Maybe I can see you being like, but like, listen here, like, I'm really busy, or like, we're not really friends anymore. I can just see you, like, you know, not really talking to them as much, and I can see them being like, oh, so you think you're too cool for me now, type vibe, you know what I mean? Or at least that's how they're busy interpreting it, you know. But yeah, anyways, so with the skeleton card, I really do get the vibe where it's like they're just really, like, you know, stressed out about, like, you. Yeah, I feel like they're really stressed out about you, for real. But it's like they're saying, I don't regret it. So I do get the vibe where it's like they're saying, a part of them kind of feels like you left them out or something, or they feel like you got better recognition, or they feel like, you know, you got an unfair mark, you got something that they wanted from you, basically. But the vibe is also saying, like, they want you to listen to what they have to say about something as well, you know. Because maybe you're busy ignoring their text messages. And I can see them saying, like, listen, just talk to me. Like, we need to talk right now. Mm-hmm. Yeah, talk to me. And then with the King of Swords, I feel like there's someone that definitely is very quiet, though. I feel like there's someone that, like, low-key, this person reminds me of Boss in The Hormones. If I can, I will link down a video. I'm not sure if I have a video, but, like, I can. I'll see if I can. I don't know why I did this. I was going to put down the link of you. But, like, I'll check if I can link down a video. But I just feel like it's someone that definitely could be a Capricorn as well. Definitely, I was getting Capricorn energy, even though we don't have any Pentacles here. Someone that's very, like, you know, soft-spoken, but I feel like they have very strong ideas and very strong morals, you know. I feel like there's someone that doesn't have that many friends, maybe. But I feel like there's someone that's kind of like, they're still very vocal about, you know, their thoughts and everything. Like, yeah. It's like they're very quiet, but, like, they have very strong opinions, basically. Their opinions are definitely louder than their voice, for real. We got the Chariot card. I can see them saying, like, you need to get to know them better as well, yeah. Or they want you to get to know them better for some reason. Like, they're saying that, like, you guys need to move on from something. Oh, you moved on too fast. You moved on too quickly. Wow. It's like a competition. I just feel like they're busy gossiping about it because you want something or you got something that they wanted from you, basically. And I can see them saying it's unfair and, like, you should hear what they have to do as well, you know? Or, like, they're saying, like, I put in so much effort in what I was busy doing and now they just got it for free. Like, they didn't even do anything. Like, how is this happening? Like, this is so unfair. Like, I can see them, like, you know, being that upset about that, basically. And then we got the Four of Wands. They just feel like this, whatever happened to you, like, they feel like it happened and you, like, put in no effort, basically, you know, with the Four of Wands and the Four of Cups, you know. I can just see them saying, like, you put in no effort, but it's kind of like you got what you wanted, basically, you know. Yeah, I've got the Knight of Wands. I just feel like they're also saying that, like, they want you, like I said, it's just that they're not trying to tear you down. They're saying they're not, it's not like they don't like you, like, they, you know, they do like you as a person. I just feel like with the Knight of Wands, it's kind of like they want you to just be mindful or pay attention to them more or something. Because, you know, the Knight of Wands talks about, you know, someone wanting to basically, you know, dial her. Like, dial her talks about someone wanting to, you know, hit that. So I kind of feel like maybe this person is, like, you know, talking about you and gossiping about you, but it's like in reality actually they have a crush on you, you know. Yeah. And maybe it's like they like you, but, like, they're trying to cover it up by, like, you know, gossiping about you low-key, and, like, that's not a good thing at all, bro, for real. Like, yeah, I can see them saying, like, you know, like, we're so compatible, like, we're so similar to each other, like, you know, like, we should definitely hang out sometime. But it's like they said all this stuff about you in the past. It's kind of like, what the actual, bro? Or maybe you've kind of forgiven this person for, you know, talking about you in the past, and, like, you really don't care. But yeah, I feel like it's someone that definitely might have a crush on you. Yeah, 1000%, this person has a crush on you, bro. And then we got the Four of Cups. They just feel like you didn't pay attention to them, and I feel like they're trying to get your attention, basically, yeah. By talking about you behind your back, basically, and gossiping about you. Because they feel like you need to pay more attention, and they feel like all the attention's kind of on you, but you don't even, like, you know, care about it, basically, you know. Like, yeah. Like, they're saying, bro, like, I wish I was in the same position as you were, basically, you know. And, like, we should try the doggy position. But yeah, guys, that's what I got for part number two. I really hope the video resonates. Let me know who this person is as well, though, for real, bro. Like, your crush is busy gossiping about you. Like, what the heck? What's going on? So yeah, I love you loads, and let's get into the next one. What is up, part number three? Let's get straight into your reading. So, who is busy gossiping about you, guys? And this is going to be such a, wow, a different type of reading. I don't know why, but I feel like it's going to be really sad for some reason. Like, okay, a side note could be, guys, like, this is super, super, super random. But, like, you might be an outie, you know, like, your belly button, like, you could be an anyone outie. Like, for some reason, I feel like either, like, you were premature or something, or, like, you were an outie, baby, for some reason. Or, like, this person might be an outie as well, like, you know, check their belly button, like, you know, see what's up there, for real. But, guys, like I said, super random. But anyways, so this is going to be your channel message, and then your overall image is going to be the inner child card, bro, for real. So, yeah, and another message was coming in as well, actually, and I heard them say, like, there's some things about me that I wish I could change, but I can't. Or, like, I heard them say something like, you can't change some things about myself, or I can't change this, or, like, we can't change this, basically, you know. So it's kind of like, what's done is done, you know what I mean? So I feel like that's the vibe that's going to be, like, who's supposed to be gossiping about you. Like, this person says something about you behind your back, and it's kind of like they're saying, listen, yeah, I wish I could take it back, but, like, we can't. It already happened, and it is what it is. It is what it is. Okay, but yeah, anyways, serious energy, guys. Like, for some reason, it feels very somber, very, like, okay, what's going on? Okay, so let's get into it. We've got the 222, 888, and the 999. Okay, we got the Devil card. Ooh, the Devil card and the inner child, guys. Oh my god, definitely substance abuse, guys. Definitely something to do with that as well. We got the Six of Cups again, my friend. Oh, damn, we got the Nine of Cups, we got the King of Wands, and the Temperance card. Wow. Like, I'm hearing them saying, I'm not interested in that anymore. Or, I'm not like that anymore. I can't take it back. Oh my gosh, guys. I'm hearing so much stuff, bro. Like, for some reason, I'm even getting, oh yeah, so, like I said, the 222, or the 22, 88, 999, and the Devil card. But I'm getting for some reason, like, you might be watching How to Get Away with Murder. Like, yeah, or something like that. Or you're, like, you might be watching a lot of crime TV shows. And yeah, I've got the inner child. So who's busy gossiping about you? Let's see. It says, it was a long time ago and I'm really sorry. I was drunk and wasn't in my right mind. I just was feeling a lot of emotions and I wish I could take it back. It feels like that wasn't even me. Guys, I'll link down a song where it's like, you know that song, Wasn't Me? I forgot who sings it, but I'll link it down below. But yeah, anyways, so with the inner child card, guys, you know what the inner child is. It's someone, it's like your inner child, bro. Like, it's, you know, your child self, basically, in yourself that you have to nurture and, like, you know, keep happy and, like, everything. So I get the vibe where it's like this person might have been very young when they gossip about you, and I feel like they still feel bad about it to this day, bro, for real, you know. Like, I can see this person, like, you know, they gossip about you, like, you know, once, like, you know, in second grade. Okay, not second grade, but I feel like they gossip about you, like, you know, once, like, literally only one time. And I just feel like they still think about it to this day, basically, you know, and, like, they still carry it on, like, their conscience, and, like, they feel really guilty about it as well, you know. I feel like they haven't ever told you about it as well. And it's kind of like, it really eats them up, basically, at night, because it's kind of like they feel really bad for lying to you. Yeah, and like it was a really long time ago as well. But yeah, the inner child, guys, the inner child, very sensitive, deep stuff, guys. So anyways, oh, there's an airplane. Anyway, sorry about that. So yeah, this person, basically, with the 222, I feel like definitely there could be someone that's very codependent on people, you know. I feel like there's someone that really needs a lot of self-assurance, reassurance on people. And yeah, I just feel like there's someone that's very sensitive, and they're the type of person that kind of like, oh, bro, it's so hard, but it's kind of like, you know, say now this person, like, I feel like this person might have even borrowed money from you in the past, definitely. And I can see them kind of like maybe lying about it, or saying, like, actually changing the story around and saying actually you owe them money, you know. I can just see them, like, you know, flipping the story and being like, no, you were the one that actually did it, you know, you were the one that did it, you know. And I can see them gossiping about you, but it's kind of like it was uncalled for, and like I said, definitely they might have been under the influence as well, you know. Like, yeah, well, like, I can see kind of them being around friends or family members, and it's kind of like they were busy egging them on. And I'm not trying to say, oh, it was the family's fault, it was the friend's fault. Like, no, bro, take accountability. But, like, I do get the vibe where it's kind of like they weren't alone, and, like I said, they were being egged on, or they were under the influence. And like I said, guys, 18 plus, and I'm not promoting drugs or alcohol on my channel at all. Please stay safe. I love you loads. Wear a mask, everything. Okay, yeah. So, yeah. And with the 8 card, I just feel like they feel very misunderstood as well, definitely. I just feel like there's someone that kind of, like, whenever they get really stressed out, maybe it's kind of, like, they just, I don't know, like, I get the vibe with, like, they feel very misunderstood by a lot of people. And, yeah, very misunderstood. Because it's just, you're feeling a lot of emotions, and I wish I could take it back. It feels like that wasn't even me. So, yeah, you know, they might definitely struggle with, you know, their mental health a lot as well. And with the 999, I just feel like they're saying, like, you know, it's complete. Like, they're saying it's done, it's over with. Like, you know, I can't take it back. I wish I could, but, like, there's nothing I can do about it, basically. And then with the devil card, again, this talks about addiction, you know. It talks about them feeling like they had to do something, you know. That they're saying, like, they felt like they had to do something. Yeah, you know, they felt like they were being pushed in a corner as well. So I feel like it was all definitely circumstantial, where it's kind of like they didn't want to gossip about you, but I just feel like it happened. And like I said, they were egged on, they were under the influence or something, or they were addicted to something, or it's kind of like maybe they were hanging out with certain people that definitely weren't, you know, the right crowd of people. And I can see them, you know, gossiping about you, because like maybe they felt like if they said this about you, they would end up, you know, getting in with the cool kids or something like that, you know. Or they felt like if they said this and they would feel better, but then it's kind of like they said it and then it was kind of like, oh damn, I shouldn't have said that. Like, similar to part number one, but more like I feel like after they said it, it's kind of like they felt really sorry, and they kind of like, even in the moment when they were busy gossiping about you, I feel like they knew it wasn't true as well, you know. Like, they knew better loads while they were busy saying it. Like, they knew they were lying, they knew they weren't being honest. And I kind of feel like they felt like even though they were gossiping about you, they were like saying, well, I know it's not true, you know, so like it's fine, basically, you know. So I kind of feel like they're saying like, bro, like, it's not my fault, like, you know, I knew, like, I know I was lying. Like, they're saying that type of vibe, you know. Because, like, literally all these cards, you're, like, you know, such good cards, where it's, like, this person truly feels like, you know, you guys are amazing friends as well, you know. Like, I definitely feel like I was a friend, or family member, like, for real, like, a friend or family member, bro, for real. And I just feel like, even you're with this younger person, like, you know, inner child synchronization and everything. So definitely be careful about how you talk about yourself as well, bro, for real. Because that also plays an influence, like, you know, on how you talk to other people and everything, and how you interact with other people. But this vibe where it's kind of like this person just felt like they ruined everything, basically. You know, I can see them, like, you know, saying something about you behind your back, and then feeling like, oh my god, like, I feel like I ruined everything, like, you're not gonna like me anymore, we're not gonna be friends anymore, I just ruined everything. I can see them feeling like, you know, really like, wow, like, what am I gonna do? Wow, guys. Sorry about that, but yeah, like, these are vibe ways, like, they feel really, like, you know, tied to you, definitely. And I just feel like they hope they didn't ruin anything, you know, between you guys as well. Or, like, maybe they said something to you, like, not to you, I feel like they said something about you to someone that was very important in your life as well, you know. Maybe it had to do with a job interview, and I can see them saying, like, stuff about you that's kind of like, oh yeah, like, I heard actually, like, they're not that good for the, like, they're not that good of a person or whatever. Like, I just feel like they said something about you, and it's kind of like they said it, but, like, they said it from a very, like, you know, emotional standpoint, and, like, a very, like I said, egged on emotional type vibe. So yeah, again, not trying to take the blame away from anybody. And with the Nine of Cups, I just feel like they're saying, it's over with, it's done, like, I can't take it back. Like I said, like, you know, they're, like, literally being like, bro, I said it already, there's nothing I can do about it. And yeah, I can also see them saying, like, you shouldn't be mad at them either. Like, they're saying, bro, you can't be mad at me, like, I was drunk, man. Or, like, bro, like, why are you mad at me? Like, I didn't even mean it, bro. Or, like, I can just see them saying, like, you can't get mad at me, bro, like, for real, you know. Like, these are good cards, though, like I said, though, you know, it talks about being, like, nostalgic energy. It talks about being very content with your life as well. So I feel like after it happened, like, they tried to move on. They tried to, you know, like, just, like, shove it down and, like, not think about it again. But, like I said, like, it was always on their guilty conscience as well. And, like, they might have even, like, not have told you that they gossip about you. But, like, if they did tell you, like, I can see them saying, like, you shouldn't be mad at them for some reason. Like, they're saying, you can't be mad at me, man, because you've done way worse. And, like, I just see them, like, you know, doing that tit-for-tat type energy as well, you know. And then with the King of Wands, yeah, they're saying, you can't be mad at me. I was just, like, you know, I was drunk. I wasn't in my right mind. Like, bro, I didn't mean it. Like, you know, even if it was, like, I can just see them saying, like, bro, it is what it is. Like, I said it. Like, you can't be mad at me, basically, you know. Not taking accountability, the Temperance card. I can also see them saying, like, you've done way worse or something, you know. Or I can see them saying, it wasn't even true, bro, so it doesn't matter. Or, like, it wasn't that important, bro, it doesn't even matter. Like, maybe they told you a secret or something, you know. Like, say they told you two secrets, bro. I can see, like, you told them one secret that was very important. Like, say now you told them one secret where it was, like, you were saying, okay, I'm wearing green underwear. And the other secret was, oh no, I was gonna say something really bad now. Okay, I'm wearing green underwear, and then the other secret is gonna be, like, I cheated on a test. So let's say the cheated on a test is, like, definitely more of greater stakes, and then the wearing green underwear isn't that much green, like, you know, that isn't that much high stakes. And I can see this person, like, you know, gossiping about you, saying, like, yeah, like, I heard that they're wearing green underwear. And then it's like, obviously, like, it's true, but it's kind of like, it's not the bigger deal, but at the same time, it's kind of, like, still, like, it wasn't their place, you know what I mean? But it's, like, yeah, like, I just feel like they're saying, bro, like, at least I didn't tell them this. At least I didn't do this, you know? Like, they're saying, I didn't tell them that you cheated, though. So it's, like, they're trying to deflect. They're trying to be, like, at least I didn't do this, you know? So, yeah, compensating type vibe. But, yeah, guys, that is what I got for pile number 3. I really hope the video resonated. I love you motherfucking so much. And let's get into the next one. What is up, pile number 4? Let's get straight into your reading. So, who's busy gossiping about you? Low-key, my camera died. I know I say that in every single freaking video, guys. I feel like I need to get a merch of literally just saying my camera died. I'm so sorry. But yeah, anyways, so we've got your child message over here. Then your overall energy is going to be the mood tracker as well. So luckily, I didn't actually read your message yet. I just was talking about the channel message, and then my camera died afterwards. So, like, I didn't get into everything. Like, I didn't even look at the cards yet. So yeah, still gonna be first impressions. But anyways, so I kind of heard this person saying, like, I would have told you if we were on better terms, or I would have told you if we were friends. But I kind of feel like this person gossiped about you, and it's kind of like they're saying that, like, they would have told you. But the thing is, you guys weren't really on good terms, or you guys weren't friends at the time. Or, like, even right now, maybe this person heard gossip about you from somebody else. And I just feel like they didn't really like they heard gossip about you, and I kind of feel like they didn't really confront you about it, or they didn't, you know, stop the gossip as well. You know, like it's sort of like broken telephone, you know, when someone tells you something and then you tell someone else something, like that type of thing where it just goes around. And they didn't know who started the rumor, and I just feel like they just basically carried on the rumor. So it's like, I don't feel like they started the rumor, I just feel like they carried it on or something, you know, where it's like they heard something from somebody else and then they just basically spread it or something, you know. So there is a vibe where it's like, yeah, they didn't start it, but there is a vibe as well, you know. I feel like they might be someone that's very petty as well, or as kind of like their mood changes a lot, you know, throughout the day or something. And I just feel like with the mood tracker card, it's kind of like you know, they might have done this when like they were feeling a certain type of way or something, you know, like maybe they were feeling like, you know, just they were feeling really picked, they were feeling like, you know, spreading some gossip or something. But yeah, anyways, who's busy gossiping? Actually, let me just take a sip of my drink quickly. Okay, my drink. And I know, guys, energy drinks are not good for you guys, it's really not. Don't drink energy drinks. But anyways, so who's busy gossiping? Actually, we got the naked girl. Okay, naked woman, let me say that rather. Well, not really naked, but yeah, anyways, we've got the smiley card that came up, right? Okay, the shine card, we've got the eight of swords, we've got the tower card, the page of wands, and the six of wands. Wow, this person definitely might be very popular as well. 1000%. I'm definitely getting, you know, Libra, Gemini, Aquarius type vibe. But yeah, I'm getting like they could be in high school or something, or I just get the vibe where it's like maybe you're an intern somewhere, but it feels like you guys are very young. Like maybe you guys are in your 20s, you know, 30s, 40s or something. You guys could be any age as well though, but like I'm getting like it's very young, youthful type vibe here. But anyways, so yeah, we've got this card over here. Okay, then we've got the shine card here, and then we've got the mood tracker being the overall energy. So yeah, yours are the moods, guys, as well. We've got sad, angry, can you guys even see? Sad, angry, jealous, happy, in love, confused, and envious. Ooh, okay. Or nauseous, actually. But yeah, anyways, but now y'all can't even see all the cards. No, no, no. Let me know what setup do you guys like more. Like, I feel like I need a better setup, guys. Like, I'm super sorry. But yeah, anyways, let's get into it. So it says, we don't really talk ever. Wait, we don't really ever talk. We're not friends either. My friends don't know your friends. It's just for fun. Don't take it too seriously. I got nothing against you. I just talk about everything. Was it true? Wow, powerful. That's really interesting. So I definitely feel like this might be someone that kind of like, yeah, they really don't know you personally. But yeah, with the mood tracker card, I just feel like there's someone that's kind of like they heard something from somebody else, and it's kind of like they just carried on spreading the rumor as well, you know. I feel like there's someone that definitely they talk about a lot of things, or like they gossip a lot in general. So I kind of feel like when they spoke about you, they didn't really think it was that big of a deal, you know. If this really, like, you know, did affect you, or like if you really feel like, oh my god, like this person must be gossiping about me, like if it's really affecting you really bad, I feel like it wasn't their intention to kind of like, you know, hurt your feelings or anything. I just feel like there's someone that, like, you know, they gossip a lot in general, so it's kind of like they didn't really think about, you know, how it would affect you personally as well. Like there is that vibe as well. Yeah, and I feel like they're very curious to know about you as well, definitely. Like they're wondering, like, you know, was the rumor true about you? Because I get the vibe where it's like somebody started a rumor about you or something, or like words getting around about you as well, definitely. Like people could just be, you know, talking about your name or talking about you as a person, basically being like talking about who you are and everything as well. Yeah, like I can see people saying like, oh, that's so and so, like they do this and this and this for a living, and they do this and they live over here. Like I can just see people spreading your personal information, basically. Yeah, like your own personal information, bro, for real. Make sure all your accounts are secured and everything, and like you're safe, guys, for real, because that is freaking not okay, for real. But yeah, with this card that we got over here, I definitely get the vibe that like there's someone that's very, very, very attractive, you know. Maybe they have dyed hair, you know, big eyes, they might be very fair skin as well, you know, or like their skin's very pink as well. I do get the vibe where it's like maybe they like wearing plaited skirts or something. They like wearing plaid is coming in a lot, definitely. Getting something about wearing like, you know, fluffy fuzzy jackets, or like, you know, like just like I feel like they seem like a very glamorous person for some reason as well. Like, you know, they might be very attractive, you know, they have a nice body as well. And by nice, I just mean they might have a very lean body. Like, you know, every body type is beautiful, okay? But I feel like they might have a very lean body. Like, you know, they might work out a lot as well, you know? And it's like, if they do gossip about you, maybe they gossip about you at, like, the gym or something, you know? Or, like, if they go jogging every morning, I can see them gossiping about you at, like, the gym or something. I mean, at the, like, while they're busy going on their morning runs or their midnight runs or whatever, you know? But yeah, there is that vibe where, like I said, somebody else told them first and then they just basically carried on the broken telephone type vibe. Like, I get the vibe where it's like they're saying, well, I heard it from this person told me, and that person told me, like, it's like a broken telephone, you know? And if you guys don't know what a broken telephone is, it's a game, basically, where you just, yeah, it's complicated. Y'all can Google it. But yeah, there is that vibe, though. And with the sunshine card, I really feel like this person really doesn't know you personally. I feel like they didn't have anything malicious, or like they didn't really, like, you know, think it through, basically, you know. Like, I just feel like they heard something about you and they kind of, like, you know, just, like, you know, spread the message. They just carried on gossiping about you and they didn't really think about, like, oh, if I say this, this might have this repercussion or this repercussion. Like, they weren't really thinking like that, you know. They weren't really thinking logically, basically, as well. They were kind of just like, you know, da-da-da-da-da, gossip, it is what it is, da-da-da-da-da, you know. And then with the Eight of Swords, I just feel like they didn't really feel like it was in their control, basically, as well. Like, they're saying, like, the word was already going around. They're saying people were really talking about you before I even said anything. Like, they're saying, you know, even if I, like, they're saying, like, I wasn't the one that started the rumor. So they're saying, like, you know, like, that type of vibe as well. Like, I just feel like, you know, in the entire, you know, gossiping about you, I feel like this person wasn't the main culprit. I just feel like this might be the person that you don't know them personally, but I feel like you might know of them or something, you know, like that. Yeah. But I feel like somebody else started the rumor about you, but, like, this person, like I said, they're just carrying on the mission. They're just carrying on the rumors, like, you know, they're carrying on the gossiping, basically. But I can also see them, like, you know, trying to be like, listen, I don't want to get involved with something, like, you know, like, this is none of my business, like, you know, just don't say my name, like, don't say you heard it from me, basically, type vibe, you know, feeling very stuck as well, feeling like you can't move forward as well. So this person, you know, when they do gossip about you, I feel like they try to say, like, you know, yeah, you heard it, like, you didn't hear it from me, though, like, they will say that type of stuff as well, like, they'll say, oh, yeah, you didn't hear it from me, or I heard from so-and-so. Like, I just feel like they try to, you know, be as anonymous as possible, basically, like, gossip girl type vibe. And then we've got the Tower card. Wow. I feel like this person might be a bit jealous of you, though, for real, though. Powerful. They might be really jealous of you. I get the vibe where it's kind of like, it's like, I just feel like a lot of people definitely are trying to root against you, maybe, or something, you know. It kind of feels like there's, like, one specific person that basically started a rumor about you, and it kind of, like, it all went downhill from there, basically. Like, let me know if you're okay, Paul, for, like, what's going on with you, definitely. But yeah, I feel like one specific person tried to, you know, I don't want to say ruin you, but one specific person tried to start a rumor about you. And then, yeah, word just got around, basically, and things got out of hand, basically, yeah. And then it's like, yeah, with broken telephone, you don't know who started the rumor saying it wrong, basically, you know. Like, I feel like you guys have to Google what broken telephone is now, because I've said it so many times. But I'll explain it as best as I can. Broken telephone, basically, is when somebody hears something from somebody else, right? So, you hear this person, one person, two, right? So, one person goes, so they tell them something. Like, say that they say, the train was blue, and this person hears, okay, the train was blue. And they tell the next person, but then instead of saying the train is blue, they say the main was, I'm trying to, the train was moved. The train was moved and not blue. So they heard wrong, right, you know? And then that person's like, oh, the train was green. And then, like, it just ends up, you know, being a thing where it's like, the original story was just like the train was blue, but now it's like, oh, this person got run over by a car, and then and then Superman came down and he saved everybody, and then Batman also came. Like, it's like, bro, like, that wasn't the original story, you know. So I just feel like things got out of hand, and I can just see people, like, yeah, like, gossiping like that, you know. So it's like people definitely get misinformation a lot, bro, for real, pal, number four. Like, let me know, like, what's going on, like, what's all this drama, guys, for real. The Page of Wands, yeah, I definitely feel like people are busy talking about you in general, you know, like, a lot of different people, and And like I was getting like, you know, student energy where it's like it seems young though. And somebody busy analyzing a story as well. Like, I can see someone saying, well, I heard from so-and-so that this happened to you. But, like, is that really true? Like, I don't really believe that, though. Like, is that really possible, you know? Like, I can see some people poking holes through a story as well. So some people don't believe the rumors and the gossip and the lies. But I feel like some people do believe it, though, you know? So it's kind of like that type of vibe. And then with the Six of Wands, I really feel like was getting around, like I said. And this person that's busy gossiping about you, definitely they're very popular as well. And like I said, they didn't start the rumor, but I feel like they didn't stop it either, you know? Yeah. So that is what I got for pile number four. I really hope the video resonated. I love you so much, and let's get into the next one. What is up, pile number five? Let's get straight into your reading. So who's busy gossiping about you already? So your overall energy is going to be the did you like a card, okay? And then this is also your channel message as well. So before we get into it, like I was hearing another message as well though. Like I heard this person saying like they definitely might have a very deep voice or something, or like yeah, a very deep voice, and like they might be very short as well, like short but like they have a deep voice. But anyways, like I got the vibe that what was I gonna say now? So this person is like saying that, oh my god, like what the frick, why did like the words just like, you know, leave me? What was I gonna say now? Oh yeah, locker room talk. Like I heard this person say like, listen here, like I didn't say anything, you should hear what your friends are busy saying. Oh, I heard them say like, you should hear what this person's busy saying. So yeah, I feel like, and also I heard like something about locker room talk. So maybe this person was at the wrong place at the wrong time or something. And I get the vibe that this person is busy gossiping about you. It was kind of like they were just there when everybody else was busy gossiping about you, but they didn't really like, you know, say anything or contribute to it at all. But I feel like they were trying to get clarity or confirmation about something from you as well, you know, like maybe they try to ask somebody a question about you, and then it's kind of like that person told them the wrong information, or it just ended up being a thing where it's like, say now they brought you up, like say now your name's Teddy, because I got a little teddy bear here. Like say now your name's Teddy Bear, right? Your name's Teddy, and I can see them saying, oh, so hey guys, have you heard about Teddy yet? Or like, do you know who Teddy is? And then I can see someone saying, oh, Teddy, yeah, I know who Teddy is. And then I can see them like, you know, talking about it and stuff like that. And then it's kind of like people end up, you know, going from one thing to another thing, and like they end up gossiping about you basically, you know. So I feel like that's how it started. Like it started off very innocent, but then it's kind of like things ended up, you know, yeah, like that basically. But so we'll get into it now about who's busy gossiping about you, because definitely it might be someone that you know very well as well, definitely. Okay, so we got the strawberry card that came up, right? Mm-hmm. I'm getting something about responsibility. We've got the Friday card, we got the phone card. Also, you guys got the most of these cards as well. We got the Eight of Wands that came up, right? Yeah, you guys got the most cards. We got pile five. Yeah, we got the Seven of Swords. Wow, we got the Eight of Cups that came up, right? Yeah, we got the Ten of Wands and the Star card. Very interesting, guys. So definitely this person might be a fire sign when air sign. Definitely getting Aries, and then an Aries. Okay, I'm gonna stop. Aries, Leo, Sag. They could definitely be a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius as well, but that's the same. And maybe they have like a Mercury in Pisces, or Mercury in water sign, or Mars in water sign. But I get the vibe where it's like when they argue, they get very emotional as well. Definitely, you know, maybe they cry when they get angry or something. But yeah, so let me show you all the cards. We got the strawberry card, or the booty card. We got the I love you baby card with the phone, and then we got the Friday card, and we got two T-shirts over here as well. Okay, and then we've got the did you like it being the overall energy card. So yeah, let's get into your channel message. So it says, you told me you liked me and I thought we were getting along, then all of a sudden you started acting weird, dressing different, and I can barely recognize you. I feel like you've changed. Well, okay, pile number five, this is going to be a very juicy reading. So let me know if you know who this person is already, guys. Like, for real, that was wow. Okay, so with the did you like a card, I get the vibe with this person is basically like, I just feel like they're trying to find out something about you, for real. Like, I get the vibe where it's like they literally went and they approached somebody else that they knew you very well. Like, maybe this person was talking to your friends, and I feel like your friends might have said something about you, and it's kind of like they let something slip by accident, you know. Like, I feel like it wasn't intentional gossip. I just feel like maybe your crush or someone you used to talk to in the past kind of asked your friend a question about you, and then they kind of answered too truthfully, you know what I mean? And then I can see your crush being like, what? And then kind of like, you know, telling people. So it's kind of like like that type of vibe, where it's like the cat's out of the bag type vibe, you know. So it is gossip. Yeah, it definitely is gossip though, for real. Because yeah, I feel like this person was trying to find out something about you, basically. But like, they were trying to find out, yeah, something about you. Because with the did you like a god, I feel like this person definitely had a crush on you in the past, and I can just see them, like, you know, finding out, like, oh, like, so how many partners have you had? Or like asking people, like, you know, so have they asked about me, have they spoken about me before? And I can see them hearing an answer that they didn't like, though, you know. Like, maybe they felt like the number that you had was too high. Maybe they felt like, oh, you haven't spoken about me yet. And I can see them getting like, oh, okay. Well, like, you know, getting like salty type vibe, you know what I mean? So it's kind of like they were wondering, like, why have you not spoken about me? Or why, like, yeah, why aren't you serious about me? Or like, why don't you like me anymore, basically, you know? Like, this person feels like you don't like them anymore, basically. Yeah, definitely. And with the Eight of Cups, you know, this talks about walking away from a situation, being overwhelmed. Yeah, being overwhelmed, overworking yourself. And Seven of Swords, you know, talks about sneaky energy basically as well. So with the Booty card, definitely this person is like freaking following you like a freaking dog, bro, for real. Like, no tea, no shade. I'm not trying to call anybody a dog. I just get the vibe where it's like this person definitely is really, really, really obsessed with you. I feel like they like you a lot, and I feel like they find you to be like, you know, very sexually attractive as well. Definitely, you know. There's a vibe where it's like they like your booty for real, or they like your clothes, or they feel like whenever they see you in person, like, they're just like, damn, like, you look so good. And yeah, like, there's that vibe about you, bro. Like, definitely, I feel like it's someone that likes you a lot, bro, for real. But I feel like this person like follows you though for some reason. Like, I get the vibe where it's like they follow you in person, bro, for like real. Like, make sure like you're safe and everything, because that's weird low-key. But yeah, it's like they follow the gossip, you know. Like, if someone's like, say now they were like, you know, asking, so do you know what class I have next? I can see like them asking somebody that question, and I can see them like, you know, following your class, like, you know, trying to find out like, you know, where you are or something. Or if someone says that they're like, say now someone asks, like, says that like, oh, you've had like 4 partners, I can see them like, you know, talking to your partners, your past partners, and being like, so I heard that you dated this person, and like that type of vibe, you know. So it's like they follow the gossip basically. Yeah. And then we got the phone call card. So I feel like this person also might be trying to get your number as well, definitely. Like, I can see them messaging you soon, or I can see them trying to get your number to message you. And like, they want to ask you out as well, definitely. But I feel like they're very concerned about your past partners for some reason. I can see them, like, you know, trying to be like, how many people have you slept with? Or like, are you single? Are you not single? And I can see them, like, you know, trying to find out basically your relationship status as well. Or trying to find out your social media as well. Or something like that as well. And then we got the Friday call. So definitely something might happen to you on a Friday, bro, for real. Let me know. Like, what's the day today, guys? Oh, today's Saturday. So definitely something might happen to you on a Friday. Like, next week Friday or something, you know. I mean, I'm going to upload this video probably on, like, a Tuesday or something. Like, I don't know. But, yeah, anyways. Yeah. I mean, with the Star card, we got the Star card again. Synchronicity. Definitely there could be an Aquarius as well, bro, for real. An Aquarius is really stalking about you, bro. Like, I do get the vibe, but it's, like, low-key. If it isn't someone that likes you, I feel like it could be your best friend that's like concerned about you though, maybe. Because it does say here that they can't recognize you, they feel like you've changed. So maybe one of your friends kind of feels like you're going down the wrong path, or one of your friends kind of is like, you know, but like they're worried about you or something, you know. And I can see them like, you know, gossiping about you, or like talking about you behind your back. And it's kind of like, yeah, it's low-key kind of like we have to find the actual definition of what is gossiping. Gossiping is when you talk about someone behind their back without their knowledge, right? Right, so I guess this does fall under gossiping as well, you know. Yeah, you know, you might be dressing differently, and I can just see this person kind of being like, you've changed, who are you? I feel like I don't know anymore, what da 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 da. Bro, that's Taurus energy, bro, for real. They might be a Taurus as well though, 1000%. The Eight of Wands, like, I get the vibe, it's like, yeah, they follow you for some reason. Well, I feel like this person might be a bit inspired by you or something like that, and it's kind of like they want you to, like, you know, stay the same. Like, they don't want you to change, basically. Mm-hmm. Or I just feel like people always ask, if it is a friend that's busy gossiping about you, I feel like people always ask your friend questions about you, and then it's kind of like they will answer, but like sometimes they'll say things that aren't exactly true. Yeah. And then instead of being like, oh, I don't know, like, they'll try to make up an answer, basically. Yeah, bro, for real. Like, that's how they gossip about each other. They'll say things, and then, like, because they don't know the actual answer, like, they'll just make up things, basically, yeah. Seven of Swords, like, say they spread lies about you, bro, for real. They spread lies about you. Like, if somebody asks them, oh, so, do you know where so-and-so is? I can see them saying, oh, no, I don't know where they are. And it's, like, little lies, but I feel like it, like, low-key piles up, though. Like, yeah, they lie about you, bro, for real. Sneaky energy, you know, having a sneaky friend. It talks about also struggling to move on from a past relationship as well. Someone being bitter about you. Yeah, someone from your past being bitter about you, your present, your future, bro, for real. Yeah, being stuck in the past, basically. The Eight of Cups. I feel like maybe this person might have walked away from you. I can see this person's, like, saying, like, this person might have broken up with you, left you or something. And I feel like maybe they told you, like, oh, I don't want to be your friend anymore. Or I can just see maybe you walked away from them. Because it does say that you started acting differently. I thought we were getting along. So, this person could just feel like maybe you walked away from them. And, like, now they're really sad about it. And, like, they're trying to find out, like, you know, why did you walk away from them? Or, like, I can see them, like, you know, asking people, like, you know, hey, do you know what's wrong with so-and-so? Like, they're acting really weird. Like, we were talking for a while, and then they just started acting differently to me. I don't know what's going on. Like, I can see them, like, you know, talking like that, basically, about you. Like, it sounds like it's, like, they're concerned, but at the same time, I feel like also maybe another person's also gossiping about you, and, like, it's not about them being concerned. Like, actually, it's just them lying about you, you know. Saying things about you that aren't true. Ten of Wands. This person definitely feels very overwhelmed right now as well. They just feel very bombarded by you, basically, your energy or you. Like, you're stressing them out for some reason, stressing them out. They feel like they want to work things out with you as well. Like, they're saying, like, you know, can we work this out? Can I get another chance? When am I going to see you again? Will you forgive me? Like, they're asking so many questions about you, bro, for real. Yeah. Yeah, bro, for real. Like, it's sort of like saying that this person wants to find out something about you. Like, they want to find out, did you like it, bro? Like, they say this question, right? And then they go and they ask literally, like, the janitor. And it's like, bro, how is that person going to know anything about you? So then obviously, or I just feel like they ask, like, someone that doesn't even know you, bro, for real. Or this person might feel like they're talking to one of your friends, but it's like that person isn't your friend, bro, for real. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like, I'm looking at, like, an arch nemesis. But, like, nah, I feel like that's a bit too extra, though. But yeah, Pearl 5, that's what I'm busy getting for your reading. Let me know if the video resonated. I love you so freaking much, and let's get into the next one. What is up, Pile Number 6? Let's get straight into your reading. So, who is busy gossiping about you, alrighty? So, we've got your channel message over here, and then your oval image is going to be the spam card, alrighty? So, yeah, and also another message was coming in, Pile Number 6, before we get straight into it. I heard this person saying something like, I feel like this person definitely has a lot. Okay, maybe actually you might have a lot on your chest while you're busy watching this video, and I can see you maybe watching this video to get some clarity or something, and I get the vibe where it's kind of like, you know, maybe you've tried to talk to this person in the past, and I kind of feel like maybe they were very dismissive, or it's kind of like every time you try to talk to them, they would block you, they wouldn't want to talk to you, and then it's kind of like you were left with no choice but to kind of maybe say something about them. Or maybe you met this person and you had a very bad experience when you first met them, and then maybe you told someone about it, and then I can kind of see it getting out of hand. I can kind of see it, like, maybe you started a rumor about them, but, like, I get the vibe where it's kind of like that's what at least they're busy saying, that they're saying you started the rumor about me, and I was just trying to defend myself, basically. Like, literally that's what the channel message says as well. So, like, there is a vibe where it's kind of like that's what they're busy gossiping about you, because they're saying, like, oh, you started it, you know what I mean? But, like, there's a vibe where it's like it's so, like, immature, where it's kind of like you try to talk to someone and they're like, talk to the hand. So it's like, bitch, what do you mean talk to the hand? Like, are we in, like, third grade? But yeah, so let's get into it. Pile Number 6, who's busy gossiping about you, guys? We got the dog card that came up, right? Okay, or the loyal card, okay. Okay, we've got the pretty girl. Okay, we've got the Two of Cups that came up, right? Ace of Pentacles, the Page of Swords, and the Emperor card. Wow. Yep. Just as I thought. Wow. Okay. Anyways, I don't know why I was getting distracted for some reason. So yeah, I've got the spam card, being the overall energy, and then we've got the pretty girl, and we've got the loyal card that came up, right? But yeah, let's get into your channel message. So it says, I have no idea what you're talking about. I just defended myself because I heard you started this rumor about me. I just came to set it straight. Also, they're not single. And then in brackets it says jealous ex. Oh my gosh, guys, like, not a jealous ex. I got the vibe where it's like somebody might be dating your ex right now, and I can see them, you know, spreading rumors and lies about you, basically, but for real, like, I get the vibe where it's like this person that's busy gossiping about you might have been in a committed relationship before you, or I feel like maybe you were seeing someone that was in a committed relationship, and I can just see their partner, you know, finding out and getting very jealous and, like, you know, spreading lies about you, basically. So whoo, guys, that's a lot of energy. So yeah, with the spam call, like, I'm getting the vibe where it's like, yeah, I really, like, you know, not wanting to talk to somebody, not really wanting to speak to them, just ignoring someone, blocking them. You know, when you get an email, you know, sending it straight to spam as well, and just not, like, really bothering to check up on someone, basically. So I do get the vibe, but it's kind of like this person didn't really talk to you before they really spoke to anybody else as well. Like, I do get the vibe where it's like maybe you met this person and, like, you didn't have a very good experience with them when you first met them, you know, like, maybe you met them and they were, like, you know, just, like, really rude to you, and you were trying to, you know, like, blow off some steam, or it's kind of like you were just trying to tell your friends, like, yeah, like, I met them. Like, maybe you met someone that you've always wanted to meet or something, and I can see you saying, like, wow, yeah, I met them, and, like, it was not nice. Or maybe this is them, you know, I can see them saying, like, yeah, I met them, and, like, it wasn't nice, like, you know, they were so rude to me. And I can just see people, like, finding out, being like, oh my god, like, yeah, like, apparently, like, they're really rude, or apparently this happened, like, that type of vibe, you know. So it's like people really can gossip about anything, guys, for real. Like, people even can gossip about, like, freaking you eating, like, Cheerios for breakfast, bro. So it's like at this point it's kind of like it is what it is. So yeah, with the loyal card, I do get the vibe that it's kind of like I do get the vibe where it's like this person might have been in a committed relationship or something like that. Like, I get the vibe where it's like there was a third party involved, or I can see some people even trying to defend you behind your back as well, definitely. So I definitely feel like not everybody's busy gossiping about you. I feel like there's only one person that's busy gossiping about you, if anyone even is gossiping about you, partner number six. For the most part, I feel like people, like, you know, feel like you're a really nice person, basically, you know. They feel like, why would anyone have anything bad to say about you as well, you know. Like, maybe now I'm getting the vibe, but it's like maybe somebody met you and they felt like you weren't really nice when you first met them, and then I can see them trying to tell other people, like, yeah, like, you should stay away from this person, like, you know, they're not a nice person, they're so rude. And I can see people being like, what, this person being rude? Like, no way, like, bro, you must be mistaken, like, they're such a nice person. And I get that vibe as well, definitely. And sorry if you guys can hear all this shouting at my house, but yeah. And then with the spring goal card that we got over here, I do get the vibe that, like, this person might be someone that's just, like, seems very innocent, very shy, and yeah, like I said, this person's trying to defend themselves or something, you know. So yeah, it's similar to, you know, when you're doing a class oral, like a presentation in front of school or something, in front of your class, and then it's kind of like, okay, now this one person went and they were amazing, bro. Like, literally, they were so good. They had a presentation, they had cue cards, they had like slideshows, like, they had everything, they had snacks, they had everything, you know. And then it's like, okay, now it's your turn. And then it's like, oh frick, now obviously anyone that has to go after this person, like, it's gonna make it look like your presentation is, like, way worse than it actually is. And it's like, your presentation is good, but it's kind of like it isn't as good as theirs, you know. But, like, it's gonna look even worse now, you know. So I just feel like this person is, like, saying, like, they feel like they look so worse next to you. I just feel like this person's, like, trying to, like I say, defend themselves or something. Like, I just see them, like, you know, being, like, all innocent, being like, oh my gosh, no, me, like, what do you mean, like, I didn't do anything, like, I was just trying to defend myself. But it's like, okay, sis, okay. But yeah, I can see them trying to act, you know, innocent, basically, definitely. But I definitely feel like it is someone that's very jealous of you. Yeah. And then we also got the Two of Cups that came up, right? Mutual feelings. So I can definitely see this person saying, like, I just get the vibe is that they're saying that they genuinely didn't mean to say anything rude about you. It's kind of like they just felt like it was really true, or that they're saying like, listen, just stay away from me, but like when I first met you, like I was being honest, it wasn't nice, you were actually really rude to me, da 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 da. I can see them saying that, you know. So there is a vibe as well where you're saying, okay, you're right, maybe I could have been nicer to you, and I can see you guys trying to have a civil conversation as well, definitely. So this person definitely might approach you soon and actually tell you to your face, like, listen, I heard you're busy spreading lies about me, or like, listen, I said this about you, it's true, I feel like we should just, like, you know, stay out of each other's lives, and da 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 da. I can see someone actually coming to you and saying that to you as well, definitely. But there is a vibe where it's like feelings are involved in this as well. So maybe you're seeing their ex, vice versa. So it was kind of like just feelings are involved in this, bro, for real. Or like even maybe your friend could have feelings for you. And then I can see it kind of being a vibe where it's like you're trying to, like they're trying to act like they don't have feelings for you, bro, or something. Like someone's trying to cover up something, basically. The Ace of Pentacles. A new opportunity. Like I feel like you're going to end up talking to this person and then they're going to say, listen, I feel like we should just stay away from each other because clearly we're not going to agree on anything. So it's just like, you know, stay out of each other's lives, basically. I can see them saying that to you. And I can see you being okay with that. I can see you being like, okay, it's fine. Like, bro, that's fine with me. Like, I have way more other things to, like, you know, to worry about. Like, I'm busy with other things as well. And we've got the Page of Swords. I can see you being so busy and see so preoccupied with other things that literally this doesn't even affect you at all, bro, for real. Like, this person's, like, you know, so stressed and pressed about you, but you're, like, bro, emperor energy. You're, like, bro, I'm busy. Like, I got schoolwork to do. I got money to make. I got to worry about my partner. I have a pet to take care of. I need to take care of my looks, bro. Like, you're saying, bro, I'm busy. I'm busy, bro, for real, you know, with the Empress card. The Emperor card. It's like, you're in your own energy, and this person, like, slowly so pressed about you, bro, for real. Like, I can just see this person coming up to you and being like, yes, it was me. I gossiped about you. It was me. And I can see you being like, huh, what are you talking about, bro? Like, I don't even know what you're talking about. Like, for real, bro. Like, you don't even think about this person, but, like, this person's, like, thinking about you all the time. For real, bro. It's actually similar to, like, you know, when you have a very embarrassing moment that happens to you, and then it's kind of like you think about it all the time, and then obviously to the person that was embarrassed, like, you're going to be thinking about it all the time, but to the person that, like, but to the other person, it's kind of like they're not even thinking twice about it, you know? Like, actually, I read this one thing, like, oh, that's the end of the reading, guys, but, like, I read this one thing that says something like, if you ever feel like really embarrassed, or like you get really like you get like a cringe moment, like you're like, oh my gosh, like why did I do that, try to think of one time that somebody else was embarrassed in front of you, bro. Or try to think of somebody else's most embarrassing moment, and like for the most part you can't think of one, right? And that is like basically how people feel, you know. So it's like, anyways, I feel like I'm rambling. But whenever you feel really anxious, whenever you feel like, you know, something happened to you that was so embarrassing, just try to think of somebody else's embarrassing moment and like just think about how like it passes. It's not that important, you know. But anyways, I'm gonna stop rambling, guys. I love you so much. And that is what I got for part number 6. I really hope the video resonated as well. Please comment down below other video suggestions. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one.